Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sanibona bazalwane. Good evening, good evening, good evening to everybody watching us. YouTube, Facebook, good evening. What a joy to be here once again. On this Friday, bazalwane yePasika, on this Passover Friday, we are so excited. Egameni lika Jesu Christu, we are in that spirit of the Passover. In the name of Jesus, I want to talk to you for a few seconds under the subject, My God, why have you forsaken me? In the book of Mark chapter 15 verse 34, Mark chapter 15 verse 34, and at the ninth hour, and Jesus cried out with a loud voice saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? Father, we thank you for your reading, for the reading of your word. It is life and it is power to us. Hallelujah. This was the fourth word on the cross uttered by Jesus when he was dying on the cross. And I want you to know, bazalwane, ukuthi Jesus died on the cross, but not Christ. Not Christ. Jesus died, but not Christ, because we know now there's a difference between Jesus and Christ. These are two people. And when you read the book of Isaiah, you find something very interesting. The angel came to Mary and said to Mary, in fact, Isaiah said, unto us a child is born, but a son is given. A child is born, but a son is given. Meaning, Mary, don't confuse the two. You are the mother of the child, but not of the son. Don't confuse the two things. You are the mother of the child who is to be born, because you can't give birth to the son. The son was already there before you were even born, Mary. So you will be the mother of the child. Unto us, a child is born, but not a son. A son I already had, I will give it to you. I will give him to you. You will give birth to the child, not to the son. So don't go around, Mary, confusing people and telling people you gave birth to Christ, the son. No, you gave birth to Jesus. And Christ was inside now, the body of Jesus, redeeming the world to himself. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So here, bazalwane, das funda khona, Mark chapter 15, verse 34. And he began to cry out with a loud voice. Who now? Who is crying? He cried with a loud voice, Christ, and said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, my God, why have you forsaken me? Very important as we are about to close. For the very first time in his life, Christ experienced the pain yokushiywa ubaba, the pain of being alone, the pain of doing things without God doing these things with you. He felt disconnected from God for the first time, and he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? This is Christ on the cross, crying out loud to God, why have you forsaken me? In other words, Christ is bringing a dimension, and a very important one. He is telling us this thing. I cannot pretend as if God is still with me and carry on doing business as usual. I cannot pretend to do business as usual as if the Lord is with me. He said, my God, why have you left me? I cannot continue doing this without you. I cannot continue preaching without you. Now, the pain of this generation, inkinga yethu bazalwane, thina sifana noJesu, uJesu akakwazanga to carry on without God. Thina siyakwazi to carry on without God. We know how to preach because we've been taught. We are eloquent speakers. We know how to preach without the presence of God. We know how to continue singing in our praise teams, shouting and speaking in tongues without the presence of God. But Jesus stopped there and there and said, I feel disconnected, I cannot continue. I know I'm Jesus, I can preach, I can do things. I know people have not seen this side of me. They know me as this powerful man, but I feel and I know that right now things are not the same. I have been disconnected from God, and it stops right here. I won't continue. My God, why have you forsaken me? He is teaching us, don't continue when you know that you are disconnected from God. Stop and seek him. Don't continue with church as usual. when you know you are disconnected from God. Don't continue when these zintos are saying, I love these guys who were in the wedding in Cana. After seeing uguti wine say pelile, they spoke to Mary and Mary went to Jesus. In fact, the Bible says only a few people noticed something. Look at this now. The wedding was continuing. The people were dancing, clapping hands as if everything was okay. But a few people said, we cannot continue under this arrangement. The wine is finished. We can't pretend as if the wine is still there. Let us go to the winemaker, to Jesus, and tell him, it is so sad that people are continuing even though the wine is finished. But people are continuing. Hallelujah. That is why now we don't see the power of God. We don't see lives changing even in church because we are just continuing without the wine. And they went to him and they said, we noticed something. The arrangement now is abnormal. We can't continue because the wine is finished. Please come and help us. And Jesus came and he helped them. Hallelujah. Because they refused to continue as if things were still the same. That is why abantu abashintshi, they don't change because they continue to apply themselves in the things of God. Bangafuna ukushintsha, bangafuna ukuphila impilo ekufanele iphilwe, bangafuna ukushintsha their current in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. But I believe in a church. Kubazalwane, who will say ngolunye usuku, pastor, I cannot do this in church. I know you assigned me to do this, but my wine is finished. I am still seeking the face of the Lord. I cannot run the program of the church today. I cannot be the MC. My wine is finished. Please forgive me. I cannot sing today. My wine is finished. Please forgive me. I cannot preach today. My wine is finished. I am running on empty. Let me go to the Lord and seek the face of the Lord. Things are falling apart because people are continuing, yet the wine is finished. He said, Father, why have you forsaken me? My God, why have you forsaken me? Hallelujah. It is Samson who made this mistake in the Bible of continuing even when he had no power with him anymore. The Bible says, umazohlaselwa amaFilistine, the Bible says he woke up, he arose thinking that he still had the power. Kanti inwele zakhe zasezisusiwe kuye. Lithi iBhayibheli bambamba kalula uSamson. Because he had no power. Sometimes we continue thinking we still have the power, but we have nothing at all. And they asked him, please dance for us, perform for us. For the very first time, Samson danced for them. Because all you do when the anointing has left you, you are just performing. Even when you are preaching, singing, it's nothing but performance. You are performing for us because the anointing is departed from you. Everything you do outside the presence of God is mere performance. I don't care you preach and you run on top of every chair, run around the church and the people are standing up and clapping, but you know you have no wine. Listen to me. It is unfair to want people to come to you when you know you have no fire, you have no wine. It is unfair to advertise posters all over, come to this revival, you know you have no connection with God, you have no wine. It is unfair to call people bears, false advertising, and when they come, they don't get what you advertised because you have no wine. In the mighty name of Jesus, our prayer tonight, God bring back the wine. God connect us again. God don't leave us. In the name of Jesus. Father, I pray. In Jesus' mighty name, ngiyathandaza. Moya kaNkulunkulu, bring back the wine. In the mighty name of Jesus, sisize moNgcwele. Egameni likaJesu Kristu ophilayo, ususe amandleni, usise amandleni. Let us be a church that will refuse to continue without the fresh wine, the fresh anointing, the fresh power coming upon us. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray for all nations of the world under the sound of my voice right now. In Jesus' mighty name, that you bless each and every body of us. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, bazalwane. The Lord bless you. The Lord increase you. Ekameni kaJesu kule Friday. In Jesus' mighty name, use our church accounts that are on the screen and begin to give now. Hallelujah. And I thank God for all those who are giving. The people who have been so loyal and faithful and they are giving. That is what the gospel is about. Again, I say to you, church is not closed. Only buildings are closed, but not church. Church is continuing. I'm coming to you live right now because church is not closed. Hallelujah. So continue giving your offering and we are praying for you and the Lord bless you and increase you in Jesus' name. Amen.